Welcome to the fall edition of the Capstone. I'm Sergeant Tim Beery. In today's edition, we wish a fond farewell to Major General Brian Tarbett and Command Sergeant Major Bruce Summers. Wildfires keep the Utah National Guard busy, and veterans retire flags in Spanish Fork. But first, Sergeant Chloe Barnes takes us to Army Garrison Camp Williams, the site of Governor's Day 2012.
I am here at Governor's Day 2012. We have the soldiers and airmen of the Utah National Guard lined up, ready to go as the governor inspects the troops. And we have the families, as usual, watching from the side. Today has a very special meaning for Governor's Day as Major General Brian Tarbett and Command Sergeant Major Bruce Summers retire and hand off command to the new leadership. We got our cameras in front of them one final time so they could give us some advice and some final words to the Utah National Guard.
12 years ago this month, I came into this job in a driving snowstorm. So bad that we had to cancel Governor's Day and move the ceremonial part inside. Little did I know that that was a perfect indicator of things to come, because right after we had the events of 9/11 and then both wars, and been a tumultuous time. It's been the most profound privilege I think one could ever have. I mean, these are serious times, and they require serious men and women. And fortunately, we've had them.
Some of the best experience we've had are having the opportunity to go see soldiers and airmen across the pond, so to speak, working in harsh environments, but doing a great job. And everywhere they go, the Utah Guard always makes a reputation for themselves.
We've never called upon this organization to do something that it hasn't been able to do.
Just watch those young mothers holding the babies as their significant others leave and go is just very difficult to watch. Homecomings are great. Love to bring them home.
Every time.
I would say that's probably the most difficult thing of leading the organization in a time of war.
So many highs. The Olympics, of course, were a great opportunity. I'll always treasure that memory. You know, virtually 100% mobilization of the Utah Guard, and then we had about 2,500 soldiers in from 25 other states. That was a high point. The visits I've been able to make to the Gulf, to visit the soldiers overseas, to the Philippines, to visit the 19th, those are all special. And any time, you get to spend time with the families of these great soldiers and airmen, almost invariably a high point.
My goal of my first enlistment, I wanted to be that young buck sergeant, you know. I wanted to get those three stripes so I could take care of my section, take care of these sections.
And you will be again.
I will be.
Proof.
But that was the goal. When we retire, there's some things I'm sure we look back and think, geez, I wish maybe I could have done better there. I wish maybe I'd attacked that problem a little bit better. He's absolutely right. I mean, it's the opportunity just being with these great people that is phenomenal.
I tell you, I'm a guardsman first, I'm in the Army next. The National Guard's a very special place to be. To be a citizen soldier is a deep, profound privilege. I mean, I have nothing to compare it with. It's simply been a great opportunity, a great honor.
Soldiers of the Homeland Response Force, or HERF, passed their exercise evaluation in July and currently are in the process of being validated. The mission of the HERF is to respond to man-made or natural disasters across the nation. The Utah Army National Guard kept busy this summer responding to wildfires due to the dry climate. 2nd Battalion, 211th Aviation, assisted with the Quail Fire near Alpine and Pinyon Fire near Camp Williams with UH-60 Black Hawk helicopters. The helicopters made repeated trips to nearby water sources with 600-gallon buckets to douse the flames. In August, student delegates from high schools across the state of Utah took part in Freedom Academy at Camp Williams. I got the opportunity to tag along and see what Freedom Academy is all about.
We do this because we feel it's very important to talk about our founding and where we come from and what our roots are as a nation.
I'm excited to gain the leadership skills and the experience to lead my school to the best of my ability.
Today, counselors conducted a flag detail, and they posted a giant flag on the flagpole here in Camp Williams. And then tomorrow we'll hand that flag detail off to the students, off to the delegates.
But the main thing I want you to understand today is how important education is. that you continue always to train your brain so that you can take advantage of all the unknown opportunity.
For over 200 years, Americans have shown amazing courage time and time again in the face of overwhelming obstacles.
A lot of people get really anxious about the future. They don't get to work with you guys. They don't get to work with the soldiers and the airmen that I've been able to work with for many years. We have great young people with extraordinary capacity. So thank you for giving us a week of your summer. Hope it's been worthwhile. You do live in the best country in the world. Have no illusions. Travel widely. Take every opportunity to go overseas. You'll have that lesson reinforced. In a very few years, many of you will be overseas. You'll get to see that this is truly a land of opportunity where you get to decide what you'll be and how you'll do it. Be a part of protecting that.
I'm Sergeant Rich Stoll here at Camp Williams, side of Governor's Day festivities. Back in June, I was here with the 300th Military Intelligence Brigade for Operation Panther Strike, one of the largest training exercises of its kind.
The vision was to create an exercise where military intelligence professionals would be able to step in an environment just like they would see in Afghanistan.
Well, the mission we are doing here at Panther Strike is very similar to what I've done on my multiple deployments, where they take the different MI disciplines, for example, human, your analysts, and your SIGINTers, they put them into one package, and they're able to provide support to the tactical units out and about so they can get that real-time intelligence.
There was really no blueprint for this exercise. We built our own scenario without contract support, just with guys and gals that wear this uniform every day. And we've put together a phenomenal product.
Went really well. We were trying to replicate a very large-scale military intelligence exercise of the kind that you see, activity you see downrange in theater. And we were able to do that and get the training the soldiers needed to prepare to mobilize.
The Utah Army National Guard conducted two change of command ceremonies this summer. Colonel Edward Willis relinquished command of Camp Williams to Colonel Clark Roberts, and Colonel Melata Copeland relinquished her post as commander of 97th Troop Command and the Homeland Response Force to Lieutenant Colonel Bradley Fuller. Approximately 150 Utah National Guard soldiers of the 624th Vertical Construction Company deployed to Paktia Province, Afghanistan this summer in support of Operation Enduring Freedom. Sergeant Aaron Rico with the 115th Mobile Public Affairs Detachment gives us the story.
While U.S. forces prepare to draw down a presence in Afghanistan, a Utah National Guard unit builds more housing and office space to accommodate the future consolidation of bases in the country.
Well, the project here is basically we're building three B huts.
A team of engineers from the 624th Vertical Construction Company has been at Forward Operating Base Lightning, building a series of new structures in preparation for a possible spike in personnel.
So we are going to see 5 Lightning actually expand over the next year.
The small guardsman team included carpenters, electricians, and plumbers, who each tackled multiple construction duties to complete the mission.
Each one should take about a week to build from the ground up. The first one took us about 2 because we was doing a little lot more into the training and making sure everybody knew all the aspects of the building so that anybody can do any job on the building now.
Reporting from Forward Operating Base Lightning in Afghanistan, I'm Army Sergeant Aaron Ricka.
That does it for this edition of the Capstone. Be sure to check us out on Facebook and YouTube for the latest photos and videos of the Utah Army National Guard. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you,
singing this next song, us from the rock band personally, because we've played so many times, but also from everyone else, we just want to say we will certainly miss you, General Tarbett, and see you next time of summers.
General Tarbett, he's such a great man. There's so many memories, and I've had so much fun with him through the years.
You've been a great mentor, a great commander. Appreciate all you've done for me personally, and of course for the Utah National Guard.
You've been just a wonderful general for this National Guard and for our family, and I just cherish the time that we've had to be able to have our kids in the youth program and be able to be a part of the soldiers' lives.
So Major Summers, you're an example I can live up to. I hope that someday I'm able to get to the point where you have gotten to in your career just by following the example that you've set for all of your soldiers here in the Utah Army National Guard. Thank you.
Sergeant Major Summers, we're going to miss you. Thank you for your mentorship, for your leadership, and we appreciate all that you've done. I personally look up to you, so thank you.
All right, on behalf of the 90-plus volunteers and employers supporting the Guard Reserve, we would like to thank General Tarbin and Command Sergeant Major Summers for all of the great support and help they've given us during their tenure and the untold hundreds and hundreds of soldiers that have deployed through their command and through their oversight. Thank you so much.
Thank you for everything.
We will miss you.
Thank you.
One, two, three.
Myers salutes you.
You will be a mentor around here.
We appreciate the time and the effort and the love that you put into your position, and we can really tell that you care.
Enjoy the time. Stop and smell the roses, both of you, and don't be shy. Stop by and see. We'll see you.